There's one last thing I want to demonstrate with operators, and that's how the increment and decrement operators affect assignment. We'll start by creating a few variables. And we'll also create a variable that adds all of these together. So right now our total pounds is equal to 4. Now if I use the increment or decrement operator in front of a variable, then it's applied before any other operators in this expression, and that includes the assignment operator. So if we do plus plus pounds of flour, then our total pounds is now 5 because the increment is applied before assignment. And we can check to see the new value of pounds of flour, which is 2 after being incremented. Now if instead I move the increment or decrement operator after the variable it modifies, then it's applied after the other operators in this expression, and that again includes assignment. So in this case, we've put the increment operator after pounds of flour, and our total pounds is still the original 4 pounds, but we can see that pounds of flour has been incremented to 2, it just happened after the assignment of total pounds. So you'll want to be extra careful when you use these increment and decrement operators because of this nuance. So I'd encourage you to take some time and play around with them in a playground until you feel really comfortable.